rightly saying, we've got some adaptations to do. I've been also praising every department left, right and centre. So I've got 20% reduction there. All of them are done now, happy days. And I've managed to smooth talk my way into a 20% reduction here as well. Let's see what we can do. Basically, what's the most expensive one we can afford now to save the most? For 318 or less, we've got a 272. Any advances? We've got a 284. Any advances? 284. 308. Ooh, that's probably as good as we can get. 308. 20% reduction as well. Happy days. Welcome to the Circuit of the Americas. It is mathematically possible for us to win the championship today. We have a 29-point lead over Lewis Hamilton. If he fails to finish in the points, and if we win the race, then we win the championship. They are the only two, you know, that's the only combination that will work, given that, let's say we finish second, even with fastest lap, and he doesn't finish in the points. That will give us a 48-point lead with two races remaining. Not enough. We need a 52-point lead plus. So, winning the race needs to happen, obviously. Fastest lap isn't necessary. But also Lewis finishing outside the points is also necessary for that to happen this weekend. Nevertheless, still possible. Emails, cheers, bit of rain in the race, could be interesting. It's going to be important to try and start the race on medium tyres. Because according to the weather thing, you know, when you like actually in a session and you toggle through for the race, was it 20 minutes in? I think it was 20 minutes in.
It's time for today's qualifying session to begin here in the United States. Welcome to the Circuit of the Americas. Now then, Anthony Davidson, you're not getting any younger, but you have been involved in your fair share of qualifying sessions in an illustrious 30-year career. How do you deal with the pressure when you have that one chance to deliver a perfect lap?
It's not so much about dealing with the pressure, it's more about how you approach the risk and just how much of it are you willing to take. You're constantly balancing the car on the edge of grip from braking, cornering and traction. And over the course of a lap, it's easy to get that balance wrong. And that's why achieving the perfect lap is almost impossible. As you say, I've been doing this 30 years now, and it never gets any easier.
Is that fog? What's that? No, it's just the sun. Medium tyres. Ooh. Surely medium tyres won't work. Surely not. Yeah, I think, yeah, time to set a time. I don't even know if I have the pace necessarily. I cannot see the braking zone. Yeah, whoops. purple in Sector 1, as I have been for most of the weekend, really. That is my my strength. I don't like the sun, why is it so low? Yeah, what I am worried about is that actually the grid is at the top end, so close. Whoa, that's not good. The grid is so close that, you know, how are we going to be able to get through on mediums? I don't think anyone's going to be able to get through on mediums. I mean, I don't expect we'll be able to get through on mediums, for example.
Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 31.7.
I would like to believe that I can risk... So surely, not everyone is going to gain 1.3 plus seconds, surely.
We're top of the speed trap, 207.9 miles per hour. Huh.
There we go. You'd love to see it. Both Ferraris out. Oof. K-Mag and Stroll also close to going out. I could go soft at the start of the race. If I get through. Also has some pace.
Fantastic.
Solid time, that. Very good time. Yeah, but not on mediums. Definitely not on mediums.
We're fourth in the speed trap, 207.8 miles per hour.
Oh, wow. Huh. That's pretty good. K-Mode's out. And Ricardo. Ricardo could be a threat in the race, though, because of the tyre strategy. Only if he starts on mediums, but... Ooh. So I'm starting the race on those. Banger time on those. Yeah. I think so, then I can have a clean set of them for the race and have that strategy available.
The track is pretty quiet at the moment. Perhaps we should get out there and get a few laps in. Best lap so far is a 1:32.1.
The session theoretical best is 1,000th better. Wow. I'm hoping I can get back down to the 31.3. I'm not expecting to beat Mercedes, they just look a beatable really. So the thing about Mercedes, and indeed Toro Rosso, is they've got a very balanced car. Mm-hmm. unfortunate.
Excellent lap. We're really pleased.
Solid.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves of our top three. Hamilton, the engineer, and Sergio Perez. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry. We'll be back tomorrow as we head into
That's
the Grand Prix.
Time. Pretty sure Bottas went faster at some point over the weekend, probably qualifying. Lucas Weber doing well again. Shock. But no, second solid. Second's very good. Interview or no? No. So, probably going to try and do the double soft strategy to start the race.
Well
That's
done.
What I'll aim to do.
Very solid results. You're looking good for the race.
We'll just do it after the race. No point. Go.
In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion
Excellent.
Of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since
Just
then, we've been treated to some
circuits.
Incredible
Mashed
races,
together.
Including, of course,
it's
that
awkward,
classic
really.
Wet-dry championship decider of 2015. We have 10 turns to the left and 10 to the right
fair.
Here at the fantastic Circuit of the Americas, overtaking opportunities into turn 1 and 12 at this anti-clockwise 3.6 mile track. And we should see average lap speeds of around 126 miles per hour. Anthony Davidson, a very warm welcome to you as you join me in the commentary box for today's event. They've had just one retirement in the last five races. What do you think that says about the reliability of their car?
I think they can be fairly pleased with that record so far. The first thing any good car needs is a solid, reliable base with which to build on, and they seem to have that this season.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and the engineer completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Perez, Bottas,
so
Lucas Faber,
pole.
And Stroll, Hülkenberg, Norris, Butler, and Alexander Albon, Ricciardo, Verstappen, Kevin Magnussen, and Sainz, Grosjean, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and George Russell. Gasly, they'll be starting
penalties.
Further back after an earlier grid penalty. And
sick.
Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Taking penalties. Is the soft available?
Okay, you can brake late into ramp because of the incline. It's a slow corner though, so make sure you stay out of trouble. Good luck.
Make it all personalised. Down on fuel. So, oh wow, right. If we're looking at generally about a 1:35 for lap time, Oh, a bit of maths here. Right. 35 over 60 times 11, and then add the 11 minutes. We're looking at about 17 and a half minutes for an 11 lap stint on the softs. Also, I think they've got it the wrong way round, because they're suggesting our lap time is going to be improving. Yeah, that's pretty good. Wow. Okay. I think that one gives us a pretty good chance. I can't change the tire I'm on. Okay, that's pretty bad anyway. That's not great. A two-stop might be the most viable. Also, I'm not starting at 100% either, so let's go. Oh, wow. Could get an undercut as well.
Everything looks good on the power unit cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature.
Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now.
Interesting. I don't know if it will be.
Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch.
why are the clouds moving so fast?
point, let's focus now for the rest of the race. Has been enabled. new strategy is available on the MFT. Copy. Signs of abrasion on your tyres now. They should still be good to run on, but they won't be at their best. Stopping this lap.
Absolutely don't box this lap. I'm very lucky that came out good.
Box, we're coming in this lap.
Weber is... I want to know what tyre he goes on to.
Okay, here's who we're really fighting today. Bottas and Norris.
Brilliant.
Okay, gap ahead is 3.4 seconds.
Struggling on these times now. Very much so. A lot of wear, a lot of temperature, not ideal.
Seeing cars.
Surely not. Race director. Wow, he's just out of it now. He's completely out of the race. The real race, isn't it?
MFD for a new strategy option. Copy that. Lando is in the pits. Lando in the pits.
pits.
Rain.
As you leave the pits. Release, release!
Oh my God. What on earth is this?
Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound.
My God. This is...
Disabled DRS. DRS is now disabled. Switch to overtake and have a go. Ahead is 15.5 seconds.
Thank you. I'm sure you can't testify. Sure.
Catch up with the car ahead. The gap is around 5 seconds. Heavy rain arriving within 5 minutes' time. Inters seem like the fastest tyre for now.
Consider the rain. Oh no.
Front is 6.4 seconds. Weather. We're watching the amount of standing water on the road. For now, we think it's safe to stay with the Inter. Fuel is at target minus one. Let's turn the engine down, please.
This
trailing our teammate by 20.6 seconds.
And I guess the silver lining is that even if I hadn't been held up, surely I wouldn't have been able to fight them.
We're fighting here are Vettel and Norris. Should improve in 10 minutes time. Light rain in 10 minutes. It is 8.6 seconds. With the current tyre condition. They should last a while yet, so don't worry about them. Gasly ahead, they're on old Inters. Their tyres are 7 laps old. Think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 50.3. You're dropping back by around 2/10 each lap. So I expect they fixed whatever the problem was.
Who's that? Who's speeding up? Sure.
the teammate ahead is 24.6 seconds. Vettel behind, less than a second separate you. They're on old Inters. Their tyres are 8 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:51.0. Is coming in for a stop.
Best, I'm going to be fighting for like a point or two. Let me guess, Lewis has the fastest lap point as well.
It's going to take a while to clear the standing water off the line. Don't start thinking about slicks just yet.
It's still raining.
10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes. The heavy rain is passing. We're seeing light rain about 2 minutes away. Inters look like the best tyre for now. Seconds.
14.7 seconds. But I don't think we have cause to move on to a different tyre yet. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. is 19.2 seconds.
But Albon in favour all on the ding dong. Came through Formula 2 to the end. Here comes presumably Charlie. Was it Seb? No, probably Charlie.
This is your final lap of the race. Has been enabled. DRS is now enabled.
That's not good for us necessarily, but I'm very old into this on a very dry track. This isn't fun.
Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was!
I mean, Lewis
Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions, and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today, and the results speak for themselves.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today.
Yeah, Mercedes are just generally the team to beat. I don't ever see them not beating.
So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Often my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed to secure the Constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
Horrific. maybe I could have got something even better if that hadn't happened. I guess there's no way of knowing, really. Actually, yeah, Toro Rosso probably aren't going to beat Red Bull, purely because there are only two races left now. I think it'll finish... Actually, I believe that as it is now is how it will finish, even with Alfa Romeo somewhat underperforming. Oh my, Devon Butler was 14th. That's the driver's standings. Devon Butler was 10th. Hulkenberg 4th. Not too bad, to be fair. Driver's standings is where it's interesting. Valtteri Bottas is still mathematically in the fight. He needs to beat us by 16 points next weekend, though. So either if we don't finish in the points, then he needs third and fastest lap. If we finish ninth... Wait. Let's just go. I'll work it out later. Interesting race weekend. Oh. Bit chaotic, bit of drama, bit of fuel saving right in the last few corners. Oh, that's unfortunate. Won that rivalry, happy days. I'll choose a new rival next weekend.
That's very disappointing. I know you can do better than that.
Have a day off.
Take stock of what went wrong so you can get a better result next time.
Why have I got two debriefs? Yeah, number of failings across the whole team. Yep. True. Oh, what can you do, mate? What can you do? Probably that one, yeah. Right then. We've got two races left to save all of these. Oh, wow. Oh, well, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. Oh, that's very unfortunate. That's fine. MGUK just not quite there. Oh, interesting race weekend. Weird things going on. Let's go to Brazil, put an ultimate round. Where it is possible for us to win the championship, it is not possible for Lewis to win the championship. Again, it would require something somewhat extraordinary, but it's possible. Oh, see you in Brazil.